Hi, I'm Cameron from Epiphan Video, and today we will be looking at how to set up your NDI HX camera from PTZOptics. We'll review networking and bandwidth requirements, along with how to add an NDI input to your Pearl-2 workflow and layouts, along with how to add an NDI output for streaming to a breakout room. This camera can be powered from a PoE network switch. For today's setup, we're going to be using the included power supply. NDI is a free protocol for video over IP and was developed by NewTek. NDI features a combination of high-quality video with low-latency transmission that is ideal for live video production. NDI HX is ideal for broadcast professionals, adding NDI sources to an existing network that has not been originally designed for video production. Epiphan Pearl-2 is compatible with NDI and NDI HX, which can be used to both ingest and output video. First off, make sure that the camera is set to the resolution you want to use. We generally recommend 1080p at 30 frames per second for presentations and 1080p at 60 frames per second for scenes with fast-moving objects, such as sports. More details about setting up a specific resolution for your use or region can be found in the PTZOptics user guide. When first getting set up, you'll need to use a direct connection to your monitor to access the on-screen menu. For my setup today, I'm using an Epiphan AVIO connected via HDMI to my laptop. It is here that you can find the camera's IP address. You automatically set the camera up to use DHCP with the IR remote control using the code #*4. You can reveal the camera's IP address at any time using the code **4. Now let's take a closer look at the network settings for our camera. We suggest setting up a static IP address. For tidy management of multiple cameras, we recommend sequential IP addresses, as a dynamic address can change periodically, making it difficult to manage in the longer term. Alternatively, you can make a MAC address reservation on your DHCP server. Remember that the static IP address you choose should always be on the same range as your additional devices connected to the camera via NDI, and must be on the same subnet. In the settings window, we're going to set up a name for our camera. Doing so will make it easier to identify later in the Pearl UI and is an essential step when setting up multiple cameras to use on your network. We're going to use the name PTZ-Paul. Also, in the camera's UI menu settings, please make sure that NTP Time Sync is enabled. We'll need that for a connection to our Pearl-2. Depending on your model, your NDI HX camera has two or three preset settings that you can choose from. You can choose between high, medium, and low, and click the Apply button and reboot the camera. For example, a high bitrate could be 1080-60 at 12 megabytes per second. NDI is a powerful protocol and will allow you to add multiple video sources to your workflow, but it does have its limitations. Ideally, NDI traffic shouldn't take up more than 75% of the bandwidth on your network. Let's take a look at this common setup for a network load. We've used some common devices for this example, including an NDI scan converter on a laptop showing PowerPoint slides with a bandwidth of 125 megabytes per second. That gives us an accumulated bandwidth of 125 megabytes per second, which takes up a total percentage of our network switch at 12.5%. Our next device is an NDI monitor in an overflow room at 125 megabytes per second, which gives us an accumulated bandwidth of 250 megabytes per second, taking up a total 12.5% of our network switch. We've also included three PTZOptics cameras, all on high, at 12 megabytes per second each, accumulating 286 megabytes per second, which account for 1.2% of our network switch. We've also left suggested headroom at 250 megabytes per second, which leaves us at an accumulated bandwidth of 536 megabytes per second, taking 25% of that network switch, which brings us to a total of 54% total usage, which is well within the 75% of the bandwidth that we recommend using on your network. As we saw in our breakdown of network traffic, NDI isn't just for cameras and allows us to source video from just about anything without using HDMI. For example, NewTek's scan converter, Adobe, Skype, and more. We've already set up our Pearl-2 to use a static IP address, To learn more about configuring your Pearl-2, please refer to your user guide or to our website for more information. Now that this camera and our Pearl-2 both have their static IP addresses, it's time to take a look at the Pearl UI. Open the Add Input panel from the list of inputs. Pearl automatically detects the available NDI sources on the network. And since we know the name of the camera we configured earlier, we select it from the list. Once we've added that, we can manage additional settings, including custom no signal picture and adjust audio delay if needed. With that done, we can now add this NDI camera to our workflows and layouts. We've already got a channel set up and a layout pre-configured. In this layout, we can swap in our NDI source. More details about customizing your layouts can be found in the user guide and on our website. Now that we're all set up, let's take a look at adding the Pearl-2 as an NDI output in an overflow room. In our Pearl UI, add an output to your Pearl-2 through the streaming menu as NDI streaming. Today, we covered how to set up your PTZOptics camera. We talked about network and bandwidth requirements, and we also talked about adding an NDI source to your Pearl-2. We also covered adding an NDI output for streaming to a breakout room. Making Pearl-2 a powerful all-in-one tool for your production needs. Thanks for watching. Please make sure to like and subscribe, and check out our website, epiphan.com, for more information.